Revelation 1 verses 1 to 3. 1. The revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave him to show to his bondservants the things which must soon take place. And he sent and communicated it by his angel to his bondservant John. 2. Who testified to the word of God and to the testimony of Jesus Christ, everything that he saw. 3. Blessed is the one who reads, and those who hear the words of the prophecy and keep the things which are written in it, for the time is near.
1 summer Sunday afternoon, a group of young people from a local church knocked on my door. They asked if I knew who Jesus was, if I went to church, and if I was interested in receiving a Bible. I told them I knew who Jesus was, that my parents took me to church when I was a little boy, and that I may attend their church someday. They gave me a blue NIV Bible, which differed from the King James Version that first grew up knowing. I found reading easier without words like thou, art, and thee, but it was still difficult to understand. I think I was 22, and then my father did not pass away until the following winter. I asked my father, why is the Bible so difficult to understand? I can read Stephen King and Anne Rice's novels, even comic books, but the Holy Bible is confusing in some parts. He told me that only a spiritual person can understand spiritual words. I asked him why we didn't go to church, but he never really answered, as if he didn't want a relationship with God anymore. In winter 1993, several days after my 23rd birthday, my father died. When I was 29, I went to Gastonia's Seventh-day Adventist Church, 2 miles from my home. Not long afterward, I became a spiritual person who understood spiritual words. One thing I noticed about the book of Revelation is that it is not about the church. It is not about the Jews. It is the revelation of Jesus Christ, and he is the Son God the Father gave to his bondservants. This is explained more in the Amplified Bible.
Revelation 1 verse 1. This is the revelation of Jesus Christ, his unveiling of the divine mysteries, which God, the Father, gave to him to show to his bondservants, believers, the things which must soon take place, in their entirety. And he sent and communicated it by his angel, divine messenger, to his bondservant John.
John knows Jesus, the Son of God. He wrote testimony in John 3:16, and the Christian world has read that famous verse for ages. Yet many deny that biblical truth, these churches and Christians are called non-Trinitarians. They also have to deny the fact that God made man, male and female, in his Trinitarian image.
Genesis 1 verse 26. Then God said, let us make mankind in our image, according to our likeness, and let them rule over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the sky and over the livestock and over all the earth and over every crawling thing that crawls on the earth. 27. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God he created him. Male and female he created them.
Tell you that Mormons, the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, and the Jehovah's Witnesses are non-Trinitarians, but maybe you know that already. Also, Oneness Pentecostalism is why they preach that we must be baptized in Jesus' name to be born again. These church denominations and Christians believe and teach this because they lack spiritual understanding. Sadducees were Jewish religious leaders who were not spiritual at all. The Sadducees rejected spirituality because Greek philosophy between the Old and New Testament periods of the Holy Bible highly influenced them. Therefore, they debated and questioned the resurrection with Jesus.
The Sadducees, who say there is no resurrection, came to him with a question. Teacher, they said, Moses told us that if a man dies without having children, his brother must marry the widow and raise up offspring for him. Now there were 7 brothers among us. The first one married and died, and since he had no children, he left his wife to his brother. The same thing happened to the second and third brother, right on down to the 7th. Finally, the woman died. Now then, at the resurrection, whose wife will she be of the 7, since all of them were married to her? Jesus replied, you are in error because you do not know the scriptures or the power of God. At the resurrection, people will neither marry nor be given in marriage. They will be like the angels in heaven. But about the resurrection of the dead, have you not read what God said to you? I am the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. He is not the God of the dead, but of the living.
People Israel. I have been with you wherever you have gone, and have destroyed all the enemies in your path. I will make you a great name among the great ones of the earth. I will assign a place for my people in Israel. There I will plant them, and they shall dwell in their own land.
2 Samuel 7 verse 27 for you, Lord of armies, God of Israel, have given a revelation to your servant, saying, I will build you a house. Therefore, your servant has found courage to pray this prayer to you. 1 Chronicles 17 verse 25 for you, my God, have revealed to your servant that you will build him a house. Therefore, your servant has found courage to pray before you.
I too am guilty, for here I live in a palace.
The word revelation first appears in God's word in 2 Samuel 7, 27. King David tells God that his word is a revelation. The same conversation is written in 1 Chronicles 17, and the word reveal is used there instead of revelation, but the same meaning. David has a wish to build a temple for the Lord. God denies David's wish. God promises to build David a better temple and dwelling place, much like the city that God will build and promise to Abraham and all the champions of faith, Hebrews 11:10-15. This is a divine revealing to David, much like the Bible, and the book of Revelation should be a blessing to all God's children. The Holy Bible is not like any other book that the reader can read silently to themselves for them to benefit from. The Word of God is supposed to be read aloud so that the reader is also a listener. When God made man, he made him in his image, forming him from the dust and breathing the breath of life into his nostrils. From that point on, the first man became a living soul, so says Genesis 2:7. If a person wants to hear God speak, read the Bible and read it out loud because you are made in God's image. If you want to see God's word in action, do what it says, and then you reflect the image of God by living the words you have been reading aloud. Of course, Jesus is the only begotten Son of God, but when you and I do as Father God says, we become children of his image. Do not deny the testimony of what is written in Revelation or any other part of Scripture. When you and I do, we will be blessed. When we deny or reject, the breath of life will leave with us and we will perish. God bless you all. I know his goodness and loving mercy will follow you all the days of your life. I also hope to see many of you in the house of the Lord, where we shall dwell forever and ever. Amen. Jesus loves you, and so do I, his humble bondservant Samuel Jerry Head.
Luke 2 verse 29. Now, Lord, you are letting your bondservant depart in peace, according to your word. 30 For my eyes have seen your salvation, 31 which you have prepared in the presence of all the peoples, 32 a light for revelation for the Gentiles, and the glory of your people Israel.
Are you searching for answers?